So, good day to everyone. I'd like to honor our team here. So today we're going to discuss the arguments for and against the revival of death penalty in the Philippines. So before we start, let's first define what death penalty is. So according to the Highest Dictionary, death penalty is the sentence of death imposed on a convicted criminal. So this is the most severe kind of corporal punishment, as it allows law enforcement officers to kill convicted offenders. So forms of this are lethal injection, electric chair, firing squad, and other more. So just a piece of information, death penalty in the Philippines started even during the Spanish period, as they brought the medieval Europe's penal system up to the time of Marcos. But it was abolished during Marcos by the 1987 Constitution, but then again, it was reimposed during the time of Ramos. And also, but during Estrada, it was the fact of moratorium because of the campaigns of human rights groups and especially the church. But during Maria Arroyo's time, it was totally abolished and just replaced by a lifetime imprisonment. So this discussion will quote the views and opinions of different social institutions, including the church, the legal authorities, our system as a whole. Also, this will show the arguments on why or why not death penalty should be revived.
And in addition to all of this, I invite all of you that during our last meeting, we also talk about the countries that currently implementing and abolish the death penalty as a form of criminal punishment. Currently, there are only 11 countries which are currently implementing that kind of criminal punishment, while 84 countries are still active in doing or implementing this death penalty as a method of punishing those people who committed these crimes and such.
So let's now discuss human rights and what constitutes human rights violations. So, Rain?
According to this Human Rights Office of the High Commissioner, human rights are rights inherent to all human beings, whatever our nationality, its residence, sex, national or ethnic origin, and so on. So these rights, to top these are the right of life and the right to be free from torture, which are obviously violated by this death penalty.
Thank you for that information, Marie. Let's now hear beside the church and the Catholic organization about this issue. So those yes, Krisha.
Well, according to my research, ever since the end of the colonization period in the Philippines, the church has opposed to the use of that penalty or capital punishment. However, because of the separation of church and state, they were unable to stop this decision of the governments to establish that penalty, especially in the time of Fidel Ramos and Jose Today,
once
before we push through, let us first hear the crimes and laws under and implemented during the time when death penalty was still imposed in the Philippines. So, collected information, so we can present it.
So, according to my research, Speaker finally advised that two measures would be passed by the House Representative before Christmas break. The first one is the restoration of death penalty and the lowering of the age to the responsibility.
Well, I have read something about your, what you said about the effectiveness of death penalty, but I've read that in the past few years, when death penalty was still implemented, it was not that effective.
Yes.
Change for about 6 months to 1 year. He said that they should die. So that's the reason, that's the main reason why our president currently invokes the Congress and other legitimate powers of our administration to implement that penalty. And the next one, the fourth speaker said about the current law that inhibits the implementation of death penalty. Like I said, the Republic Act number 1946 inhibits that implementation. But as we all know, death penalty is used for these crimes. But as you read currently, President Tolentino considers crimes like minor stealing, like stealing, minor crimes, and other juvenile crimes. He views it as a heinous crime also, and it depends. Also punishes people by death penalty, which is shocking because death penalty is not meant for that reason and for the purpose. For the fifth speaker, she talked about Filipino citizens. What the Filipinos think about the implementation of death penalty. Of course, unfortunately, the citizens of our country thinks that death penalty is a change for the greater good. Mainly because the citizen of this country is dreading, as I told you, that he's a thirst for change, for justice, which is currently imbalanced and not right for our country today. And for the sixth speaker, the seventh speaker discussed the arguments about the implementation regarding the NLP. For the side that agrees with the revival of the death penalty, she said that the penalty should be implemented because it's for prevention. Next is it's for retribution for those families of the victims. Then it's for self-defense. And also it's for the greater good. The change for the greater good, like what I mentioned earlier. While in the opposing side, it said that death penalty should be implemented because primarily it costs of executing costs more than the prison or prison those inmates or those people that perform these crimes. Second, Amnesty International said that death penalty limits someone's right to live. And lastly, it limits freedom of expression, it limits living, it's a human goal of punishment. So that is the summary of the third of this video.
So before we formally end this discussion, I want to hear your opinion, guys, about this revival. So for the revival of this death penalty in the country. So we will continue our discussion next meeting, maybe on Thursday, same time and same place. So thank you again for cooperating.